kasa bila ya ke yesu tema ha kuna kabisa dawa ya makosa ya your blood that was shed on Calvary, that we will be made whole again. I pray the Lord, as we break this bread together, may bring revelations in our lives, and let your word bring a difference in our lives. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen, amen. Let your home be His sanctuary. Amen. Let your home be His sanctuary. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. Whenever the manifested presence of God is, His power and glory flow out to bless people in diverse ways and in a miraculous ways. Amen. Wakati uwepo wa Mungu umezuswa chini, nguvu zake zinashuka na utukufu na kubariki mtu kwa njia ya kitofauti. Praise the name of the Lord. I want us to read a text in the book of Psalms 114 and verses 2. Zaburi 114 mstari wake ni wa pili. Biblia inasema ya kwamba, kama umefika hapo sema amen. Hallelujah. If we are in Psalm 114, let's say amen. The Bible says, Judah became his sanctuary and Israel his dominion. I repeat, Judah became his sanctuary and Israel his dominion. In this text, the manifest presence of God led the people of Israel to the Red Sea, had to make a way from them to enter to the promised land. Amen. Yani, uwepo wa Mungu uliwaongoza wana wa Israeli walipofika baharini, yani uwepo Mungu akatengeneza njia, bahari ikapatikana, ikapeana njia wana wa Israeli wafike to their promised land. Amen. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. Your home can become God's habitation. But as if you were, if you believe it, say amen. Nyumbani mwako kale kunaweza kuwa makao ya Mungu. Even your home can be God's sanctuary. Praise the Lord. Amen. The place of His manifest presence. Praise the name of the Lord. It does not matter. Hata kama unaishi Mukuru, hata kama unaishi Mudhaiga, haijalishi ni wapi, but wherever you are, in your home, that can be God's sanctuary. Praise the name of the living God. And something happened to Obed-Edom. Praise the name of the Lord. When he took the Ark of Covenant, 3 months. Praise the Lord. Yani, baraka zilijaa kwake miezi mitatu. Utajiri ukata kwa miezi mitatu. Even to the 3,000 generation. Utajiri haukuisha. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Just keeping the Ark of Covenant in his house. Praise the name of the Lord. The Ark of Covenant carried the presence of God. Na kumbuka wakati wakati Ark of Covenant ilipelekwa ilipelekwa kwa nani? Eh? Miungu miungu gaishia dagoni ikiambia kuinuka kunekaga. Then miungu ya Baali ikaanza kuvutika ikianguka chini yake. Bwana sana. Within a space of 3 months, Obed-Edom was blessed. Amen. Hallelujah. How can your home become God's sanctuary? Amen. Praise the Lord. How can your home become the sanctuary of the Lord? Number one, you can raise an altar to God in your home by observing a family devotion every day. Praise the name of the Lord. We are trying to tell God, make your home habitation. How can you make your home a sanctuary of the Lord? Number one, by raising an altar to God in your home, by observing a family devotion every day. Praise the name of the Lord. In this case, the entire household comes together to share the scripture, to pray, and to praise the Lord. Wakati mzee, wakati mama mwenye boma, na watoto wanashikana, wanasema masaa haya, ni masaa ya kumtukuza Bwana. That is it. Amen. By observing that, by doing that every day, by doing that every week, by doing that every month, that makes your house a sanctuary. Of the Lord, that makes your home a God's habitation place. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. By raising an altar, unasema masaa haya ni masaa yangu na jamii yangu, tunaenda mbele za Mungu si kufanya pale ni kumsifu na kum. Praise the Lord. As you come together, the Lord himself will show. Wakati mnashikana nyinyi wenyewe, mnaenda mbele za Mungu, Mungu mwenyewe anakujanga, anaketi katikati yenu. Remember what Jesus said. He said, wherever two or three have gathered in my name, I am in their midst. So when you and your wife, you and your husband, and your siblings, you stand and say that this hour is our time with our Maker, God himself is in your midst. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. It is he himself that promised that mahali wawili ama watatu, mahali Caleb na mke wake na watoto wameungana wakasema tunamsifu Mungu. God said he is in their midst. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. You can be sure your home is eternally blessed. Amen. Now, when you bring the presence of God, remember, some say that in the presence of God there is fullness of joy. Hawezi kuwa na uwepo wa Mungu na ubaki vile tena. When Jacob had an encounter with an angel, maisha yake yalibadilika. Praise the name of the Lord. Now, when you do that in your home, when you make your home an altar, you raise an altar to God, that brings his presence. And his presence, when wakati uwepo wa Mungu uko na wewe, your life must change. Praise the name of the Lord. Waanze kulisema, huyu ni yule Tony tunajua. Huyu ni yule Sara. Because you have raised an altar. Bwana asifiwe sana. You have brought the presence of God in your home. Praise the name of the Lord. God said, I love them that loves me. It is the Bible. In the book of Proverbs, chapter number 8, verse 17. Let us open our Bibles in the book of Proverbs. Proverbs. Kikwetu tunaitanga ndimo. Proverbs chapter 8, verse 17. Hallelujah. The Bible says, I love those who love me, and those who seek me diligently will find me. When I say, Proverbs 8:17. It's God who was saying with Solomon that I love them. Ninawapenda wanaonitafuta.
unipenda na wanaonitafuta kwa moyo mkunjufu. Hey, praise the Lord. Wakati unamtafuta kwa moyo mkunjufu, lazima atapatikana. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. It is the Bible. If you seek God diligently, you will find him. Praise the Lord. Salimia mtu mwambie hii ni ya mashujaa. Praise the Lord. Sara, how can you make your home a sanctuary of God? Number two, you can host a true man of God in your home. Challenge. Acha niulize swali. Tony. 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 Nimekuita mara ngapi? Have you ever invited your spiritual father in your house? Have you ever? Zinijibu. Caleb. Caleb. This is the challenge. Have you ever nyang'anya kuku kichwa because of the man of God? Praise the name of the Lord. By hosting a man of God in your house, it can make you a home an altar. Praise the name of the Lord. It can bring the presence of. Ile nyumba is why kosa hunga. Kama wewe ni Mluya is why kosa ingoho. Wewe ni haita why kosa modokoi. Praise the Lord. By hosting the presence of God. Amen. Remember the men of God. They are the grace carrier. Not even grace, even the presence of God. Hallelujah. This is what the Shunammite woman did. And the presence of God, through his anointed servant, removed her barrenness permanently. Amen. Kuna mama alikuwa a Shunammite woman. Alikuwa mzee na hana mtoto. Wana sifue sana. Alikuwa ngongo inatonja na Kiswahili. Barren. Mwalimu. Inaitangwa tasa. Amen. Hii ni baraka ya kuwa na walimu kanikoni sana. Wana sifue sana. Now, this woman alimkaribisha mtumishi wa Mungu. In the book of 2 Kings, chapter number 4, verse 8 up to 37. Hatuta soma hiyo. Wana sifue sana. This woman was a barren. And she used to see Elisha and Gehazi. Wanapita asubuhi, wanarudi jioni. Wanapita asubuhi, wanarudi jioni. Praise the name of the Lord. And she said, I will make a room for these guys. Eh? Ndiyo wakikuja, wasikuwa wanapita hivi, wena asifuwe sana. And when she did so, her barrenness was removed permanently. Akaanza kupata watoto. Praise the Lord. The challenge for you, church. Washirika wengi hatutaki kuita watumishi wa Mungu kwetu manyumbani. Hata kama nikutembea tuwapigie kachai. Bwana asifiwe sana. This is the second thing that can make your home, that can bring the presence of God in your home. Praise the name of the Lord. Number three, you can host the fellowship of your church in your home. Bwana asifiwe sana. You can host washirika ama vijana, kama wewe ni kijana, vijana wenzako, wazee, mnakuja mnaomba, mnasifu. Praise the name of the Lord. This can make your home an altar of God, and it can be the Amen. Many churches are looking for homes where they can establish center. Amen. Unajua kanisa zinaanzanga manyumbani. Bwana asifiwe sana. No, we host a lot of, if we host not a lot, if we host work fellowships in our houses, it will make our houses, you know, nyumba zetu zinakuwa tu iko na press Mungu all time. Amen. Open up your home for the ark of God and let the saints of God gather to worship right in your home. Bwana asifiwe sana. The blessing that will flow shall be beyond description. When Peter yielded his boat
for Jesus to use it was a move that changed his life. Amen.
Wakati wanafunzi, wakati Petro na nduguye Andrew walikuwa wanatega, wanavua samaki, si kutega, kuvua. Mimi ni mkapa, lazima nitaenda kutea. Wala siwe sana. Walikuwa wanavua samaki. And the whole night hawakushika hadi chura. Bwana asifiwe sana. Wanafua nyavu zao ndio waweze kwenda nyumbani. And Jesus came. It is in the book Luke chapter 5. Bwana asifiwe sana. And Jesus came. When he came, akaambia Peter, I need this. Nahitaji chako ndio niweze kuhubiri. Praise the name of the Lord. Peter akakuwa na ugumu. Akakuwa na ugumu sana. Lakini akajijaza. Akamwambia ingia, akamusukuma, akampeleka mahali boti itaweza kutembea vizuri. And Jesus preached. Wakati alimaliza, Jesus told him, now Peter, take your nets. Enda ba hapa liku. Enda pale ambapo ni unaitwaje? Deep. Deep ndio sana Kiswahili. Amen. Hallelujah.
Akaambiwa enda hapo ambapo ni hariku. Bwana asifiwe. Go to the deep places. Zusha nyavu zako hapo. Na Peter wakapata. Amen. Hakagawia wenzao zingine. Praise the name of the Lord. Opening your home for house fellowship can change your life. Amen. Whatever it is you to do, I urge you, brethren, to invite the glory of God into your home. Praise the name of the Lord. God wants to come in. You will never remain the same again. Praise the Lord. In the book of Revelations, chapter number 3, verse 20. Revelations 3:20. Ufunuo. 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 Caleb. Wait a Ufuanyo. Ufuanyo. Caleb Kikwenu inaitangwa aje. Caleb, inaitangwa aje. Uko ingo. Caleb ajui. No. Behold, I stand at the door and knock. If anyone hears my voice and opens the door, I will come in to him and dine with him and with me. Amen.
Nimesimama mulangoni. Nisha. Nengo kunanga. Edrari galiga.
And whoever will open me, I will enter and we will dine together. Tutakula pamoja. Praise the name of the Lord. Inviting the presence of God, it will change our lives. Amen. Inviting the presence of God in your home, in your house, in your family, it changes lives. Amen. We have seen Obed Edom venye alifanya, alihost the Ark of Covenant to his house, and in 3 months baraka zilifurika huko. Bwana asifiwe sana. Even to the 3000 generation has equal as Meisha, and it's just 3 months. Praise the name of the Lord. I have seen a mengi ya kusema, but I want to welcome Reverend Diwakuja Pengine and God bless us. Amen. Amen. Oh. Amen. Hallelujah.